Hi, thank you for tuning in again. So, the last week we spent on redesigning the rover and the ground station. It was done for three main reasons. The ground station needed to be built and the 3D printing models had to be finalized. The clearance of the rover had to be increased. And finally, we needed to increase the surface area on the solar panel cells so we could recharge our batteries better. So if you pan over here, you could take a look at our rover. So the old design of the frame itself had mounts for the flexible solar panel cells. Each cell had the size of 25 by 63 millimeters, giving it 16 centimeters square. The length side of the frame, this guy right here, was 600 millimeters. That gives us an ability to place 23 cells, and the total of 0.037 meters square surface area. The two rods allow us to have a total of 93 cells with the efficiency of 9% and power density of solar radiation, which is about 1.3 kilowatts. The surface area of the solar cells can give us a total of 13 watts. The top side of the rover can harvest some energy, but at the same time the bottom did not. It is in the shadow. The outcome power was, because of that, it was half to about 6 watts. The solar cells mounted on the frame were mounting at a 45 degree angle. So we were faced with a problem. The first one, the frame was not flexible, and that meant that it could get stuck in the terrain. The second problem that we had was we needed to increase the harvesting power and increase the surface area, right? The 6-watt source with a 10-watt transmitter and a 40% efficiency means that it could transfer data for 1 minute, and it needed to take 3 minutes and 20 seconds to recharge the batteries for the next 1 minute transmission. So something that we actually changed: the length of our cell is 63 millimeters. If we were to place the solar cells on the opposite and the adjacent instead of the hypotenuse, even though we're using smaller cells that have the length of 45 millimeters, it would add up to 90 millimeters, which is bigger than our 63 millimeters length of the original, so when we originally had it on the hypotenuse. And that change, taking that solar panel instead of putting it on the hypotenuse and putting it on the opposite and adjacent, that would give us a new power of 18 watts. Which means that we would be able to transmit data for 1 minute, and it would take us 2 minutes to recharge our batteries. Furthermore, something that we've looked into redesigning and we're now implementing is placing two additional stands, the length of half a meter, which can hold 76 small size cells, which gives us an outcome of a power of 15 watts. So the grand total would give us 34 watts from all surfaces. And halving that gives us a maximum of 17 watt power, which gives us 1 minute to transfer the data and 35 seconds to harvest the solar energy. Now the next question that we face is, now that we're adding these new frames, we have to balance the whole system out. We have to find some areas where we could take away weight so we could make the additional changes so the system is balanced. In total, for our redesign, we will have 168 cells, and we must find these cells that are that weigh 2 grams each. So today the ground station's 3D models probably are ready to be ordered, but the rover energy harvesting mount is not finalized yet. So I know today was a bit more technical, a lot in what, 3 minutes, or how long we've been, or 5 minutes. Maybe we're gonna break this down so that, you know, there's a better understanding of this. So thank you for tuning in. We'll have an update for you next week. Thank you.